finisher in the 2017 Ice Bowl down in Talladega Short Track back in January. In the number 7 machine, he's out of Arborville, Kentucky. That's Brian Smith. Brian Smith in a Capital race car with a custom race engine coming down to complete lap number 1 here. And he's going to time in at 12.512 on lap 1 for Brian Smith. And the Smith's Guttering and Siding, Hair Essentials, Family Salon, Smith Ceiling, and Razor Edge, a sponsored Capital custom-powered machine. His second lap will be a 12.680. Next qualifier out in the 101 machine out of Talbot, Tennessee. That's Forrest Trent. Forrest Trent in 101 in a Rocket chassis with a Clements race engine out of those shops down in South Carolina. He's coming down to complete his first qualification lap. Oh, he has looped it in the center of turn 3 and 4. So Forrest Trent's going to have to make his second lap be the one that is the one that's going to be his money lap here, if you will. And he'll start down the back straight away and turn around and get a good running shot here to complete that first lap that he'll throw away and try to get a good lap number 2 in the books. He is coming to green right here. All right. So Forrest Trent taking the green flag in that Rocket Clements powered entry. Should see the white flag right here coming off turn number 4. And his time, 12.508 for Trent. And the Service 101 Trent logging, awesome design concepts. Max Dog sitting sponsored entry, 12.578 for Forrest Trent. Next qualifier out in the number 3 machine out of New Tazewell, Tennessee. That's Austin Neely. Neely in a Sweet Blomquist with a Phantom race engine coming down to complete lap number 1 of his qualification effort. He'll time in at 12.287 on lap 1 for Neely. In the Giles Industries Reese Monument, 5-star properties, Clayton Homes of Middlesbrough, Benny England Motors, Mary's Home Furnishing, MRC Trucking, Pete's Place Restaurant, Tim Fletcher Heating and Cooling, sponsored machine, second lap, 12.623. Next qualifier out in the 24 machine out of Gatlinburg, Tennessee, that is Mac McCarter. Mac McCarter in a Warrior race car with a Phantom race engine making a horsepower at 8th the hood. 12.476 on lap 1 for Mac McCarter and the A1 Electric Volunteer Speedway 411 Motor Speedway Hoosier Tire South by Pup sponsored entry. Lap number 2, 12.408. Your next qualifier out, he pilots the number 7 machine, the defending Southern National Bonus Series champion out of Austinville, Georgia. It's D-Mac, Donald McIntosh. And the Blunt Motorsports Rocket with a McKeel race engine. He's coming down to complete lap number 1. Here he is off turn number 4. 12.428 on lap 1 for McIntosh. In the Massey Electric Stires Cat Service, Blunt Excavating, Arnold's Trucking, Tennessee RV Supercenter, Cherokee Millwright, DR Investment sponsored a Rocket lap number 2. 12.317. Next qualifier out. Familiar face here at Tazewell Speedway, the number 3 out of Powell, Tennessee. That is Steve Smith. Steve Smith in a Longhorn with a Phantom race engine coming down to complete his first qualification lap here this evening at 12.103 on lap 1 for Steve Smith in the Rick Welsh Racing Hoosier Tire Diamond Shine Pressure Washing sponsored Longhorn lap 2 for Smith. Here he is, 12.318. The next qualifier out in the 21K machine, the youngster out of Ewing, Virginia. It's Mr. Showtime, Dakota Knuckles, and a Rocket XR1 with a Cornette race engine making a horsepower beneath the hood. 12.095 on lap 1 for Dakota Knuckles. He'll come down to lap number 2. And at Timberline Farms, Hills Truck Repair, Davis Brothers Roofing sponsored entry. at 12.091. Up next in the 86 machine out of Rockford, Tennessee, that's veteran Jeff Newbert. Jeff Newbert in a Warrior race car, also sporting power from a Phantom Racing engine. And his first qualification lap, 12.756 on lap one for Jeff Newbert in the Joe Newbert Collision Center. Carriage Hill Insurance, Bird's Automotive sponsored Warrior Phantom powered entry. Lap number two, 12.633. And the last car in Group A, in the 54 out of Tazewell, Tennessee, this is Mitchell Burke. Mitchell Burke in 54 out of Tazewell. In a GRT race car with a DJ's Performance Race engine making the horsepower underneath the hood. For Tazewell, Tennessee's Mitchell Burke coming down to complete lap number one of his qualification effort at 12.692. 12.692 the time for Mitchell Burke. In the Brian King Roofing, Patty Zerricker Service, Round Top Farms, Tazewell VFW Post 8779 sponsored entry. He had 12.916. As we start Group B right here in the 69 out of Salem, Virginia, current Ironman Series points leader, 13 years of age. That's Carter Miller. Carter Miller in a Rocket chassis with a Battenbilt race engine. Coming down to complete his first qualification lap at 12.303 on lap one for Carter Miller. In the Irwin Racing Supply, Brickwood Builders, River Rock, Miller Brothers Racing, Black Bull Racing, Cofield Graphics, Dirty Diesel sponsored entry. His second lap goes to 12.589. Next car out, currently second in Ironman Series, points in the 56. Driver out of Teleco Plains, Tennessee, that's Joey Standridge. Joey Standridge in a TNT race car with a J&A machine shop race engine, making a horsepower beneath the hood. And Standridge down to complete his first qualification lap at 13.174 on lap one for Joey Standridge in the J&A machine shop sponsored number 56 entry. His second lap of today, much better at 12.691. Next qualifier out. In the number four machine from right here in Tazewell, Tennessee, that's Clyde Overholt. Clyde Overholt and a rocket chassis with a Phantom race engine beneath the hood for the second generation driver from Tazewell. He'll complete lap number one. Here he is at 12.514 on lap one for Clyde Overholt in the Noah's Wholesale. Baker Tree Service, COR Bodies, Hawaiian Shaved Ice, sponsored entry lap number two at 12.486. Next qualifier out, the seven-time Tazewell Speedway Super Late Model Track Champion in the Vanover Racing 201 machine out of Knoxville, Tennessee, it's Billy Ogle Jr. Billy Ogle Jr. in a Longhorn chassis with a custom race engine, making a horsepower beneath the hood. His first qualification lap going to be 12.092 for Ogle on lap number one in the Harrison Ready Mix Vanover and Sons Concrete sponsored number 201. Lap number two, here he is, 12.128. Next qualifier out in the 144 machine out of Middlesbrough, Kentucky, that's Chickie Barton. Chickie Barton in a debuting a brand new Longhorn chassis here this week, empowered by a Phantom Racing engine. He'll come down and complete lap number one at 12.767 on lap one for Chickie Barton. In the Star Septic Tri-State Guttering, Axe Hauling, Uncapped the Gap, Yoakum Property sponsored number 144, lap number two at 12.744. The next qualifier out in his first Tazewell Speedway appearance ever in his racing career in the 1A machine, the driver out of Cumberland Furnace, Tennessee, that's Levi Ashby. Levi Ashby in the 1A, it's a rocket chassis with a B&B Performance race engine making the horsepower beneath the hood. His first lap of the night, 12.862 on lap one for Levi Ashby. Sponsored by the Wheel Shop, Tommy's Qualities Used Cars, Wheels to Go, K&F Gas and Fabrication Blue Rentals. His second lap, 12.862 on lap two for Ashby. Our next qualifier out in the number 11 machine out of Corbin, Kentucky. That'll be Tommy Bailey, the Big Show Tommy Bailey in a rocket chassis powered by a Mike Bullock Racing engine. And Bailey slides high coming off turn number four. Down to the clock at 12.902 on lap one for Tommy Bailey. And the Dependable Auto Sales, Barton Storage Buildings, Tommy's Automotive, West Haven Speed Equipment, Mills Auto, Sam's Auto Body, Scott's Auto Glass, Economy Auto Sales, sponsored entry at 12.752. Next qualifier out in the 29 machine, the driver out of Maryville, Tennessee, that is Jason Welshen. Jason Welshen in a Longhorn chassis with a B&B Performance Race engine making a horsepower beneath the hood. Lap number one for Welshen, 12.424 on lap one for Welshen in the Hidden Hollow Motorsports C&J Trucking Competition Racing Equipment Sexton Construction sponsored entry. Lap number two, 12.379. Next qualifier out. In the one out of Mossheim, Tennessee, it's Victor Thrill Hill. Vic Hill in one. It's a Longhorn chassis, of course, sporting a Vic Hill race engine beneath the hood. And Hill working off turn number four to complete his first qualification lap of the night. 12.060 on lap one for Hill in the Land Air Transport Orthopedic Institute of West Kentucky. Diamond Shine Pressure Washing Mega Plumbing of the Carolina sponsored entry, his second lap. 12.046, it's better. 12.046 on lap two for Vic Hill. And your final Super Late Model qualifier of the night, the current Southern National Series points, Southern National Bonus Series points leader in the number eight, the coach out of Murphy, North Carolina, David Payne. Payne in a Capital race car with a J. Dickens race engine. His first lap goes at 12.415 on lap one for David Payne. In the Gibson Motorsports, PPM Racing Products, Payne Excavating, American Racer, Interstate Welding, Base Racing Fuel, Schaefer Oil, sponsored entry, 12.446.
These are my top qualifiers in each group.